morning, Arthur. There.
One of these days, we'll actually get the man to help with the laundry.
I wouldn't hold your breath.
You're all right, boy. Yeah, good boy. There, boy.
Bet those horses are happy to see you.
Hello.
Don't forget about me. I'm starving.
Is this amusing to you?
Getting to where we need supplies for an army.
Good work. That'll keep Pearson happy.
Thank you, Arthur.
Morgan, bring me some materials, and I'll be glad to make something nice for you.
I reckon I need to get my hands on some materials first.
Hope you choke on it.
What do you want from me?
Hmm.
Whoa, whoa.
Careful not to work yourself to death there, Uncle.
I was thinking.
Yeah, does it pay well?
Eventually.
So, while the rest of us are busy stealing, killing, lying, fighting to try to survive, you get to think all day.
Well, it's a strange world we live in, Arthur Morgan.
Hey, you want to head into town? See if we can find anything out?
Sure. I got some errands to run.
Great. Go check the horses are ready.
If you're gonna take the old man into town, you can take us too?
Well, what you got planned?
Nothing. We'll find something for y'all to do. We always do.
We're bored out of our minds. Been cooped up here for 2 weeks now. Karen's about ready to murder Grimshaw.
Well, can Miss Grimshaw spare you?
Can Miss Grimshaw spare you? What's happened to you, Arthur? 3 young, healthy women want you to take them a robin. You're worried about house chores. Let's go.
Fair enough. You got me. Come on in.
I can't believe we're going to see civilization. Feels like weeks since we did.
Yeah, Valentine.
Very embodiment of civilization.
You ladies are going to love it.
Okay, then. Let's go.
All right. Out through the trees here, then take a left.
Yep. There we go.
Ladies, sing us a song.
Lumbago.
It's very serious. All right, I'll see what's going on.
Go on. He's an old man.
Lumbago, really?
You all right there, friend?
Oh, hey, you couldn't help me get my other horse back from over there, could you?
Sure, no problem.
Thanks. It's the white one over there.
Easy boy. Good boy.
Here. Here you go.
You're a gentleman, sir. A gentleman.
Nah, not really. I was just trying to impress the women.
Well, anyway, thank you.
Go
to Valentine.
You're turning into a regular old fairy godmother there, Arthur.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means you got a heart, a small one perhaps, hidden deep inside, but a real one. And you have it, your pulse mode lizard.
Lizards have hearts.
Well, Arthur, I'm proud of you.
To be honest, if you lot hadn't been here, I probably would have robbed him.
Well, you did.
Smell those sheep. Or is that Uncle?
Oh, very funny.
This looks like a decent little town.
Other people, finally.
Look at all that snow on the mountains. Sure don't want to be back up there.
You think we should have asked Molly to come with us?
Oh, no. Miss O'Shea is far too high and mighty now for the likes of us. Or to do any real work. She's a society lady now. Okay. Take a good look around, ladies. See what we got here.
Go left here, down the main street.
Chair's always on the right. Sure you can pick up some bounties there, Arthur.
Heaven forbid you put your head on the line.
Yeah, well, that's a young man's game.
Ooh, yes. We can get up to some mischief here, all right.
Just remember, keep a low profile.
Will you remember that, though, Arthur?
Probably not.
Let's park up down the end there, near the stables.
Oh, goddamn believable.
All right. Here we are, just like I said, the cultural center of civilization. Man at his finest.
Uncle, what are we doing?
Well, we're gonna do what any self-respecting maniac does. Put the women to work.
With pleasure. We'll start at the saloon.
Okay, just stay out of trouble and don't get yourselves noticed.
Right, I need to get something from the stores.
Okay, well, we'll see you at the general store when you're done.
Wouldn't Come believe on, ladies. It unless I'd seen it.
Imagine we're in Paris.
Come on.
Imagine Paris and Valentine.
So that's how you see yourself, is it? A maniac?
Well, in my youth, I used to be known as the one-shot kid.
Okay. I'm not gonna ask why.
You are a sad man, Arthur Morgan. But I know you love me.
Desperately. You're my favorite parasite. No. Ringworm's my favorite parasite. You're my second favorite parasite.
Very funny.
I lied. Ringworm. Then rats with the plague. Then you.
Shut up. This is the place, huh? Come on. Well, afternoon.
So, what do you need?
Hell, a drop of whiskey for a start. You know, something to pass the time while we're waiting on the women.
Always thinking ahead, ain't you?
You're looking a bit tired there, Arthur. Why don't you pick up some coffee while we're here?
Plenty out on the shelves, but I got more out back. Whiskey's on the top shelf, nearest the door.
You not getting anything, Arthur?
I don't know. Maybe. So, you're actually buying for once? Are you feeling all right?
See this? Young folk got no respect for their elders no more. What do you reckon? The lamb or the sausage?
Well, this here's a sheep town. The lamb's the best in...
Okay, if you're done, I'll meet you outside. I won't be too long.
All done.
Thank you kindly. Ah... This should do the trick.
Yep, that's fine whiskey.
That should do us. Let's go wait for them outside.
All the best, fellers.
Oh, here's to your good health, sir. And to being down here off that mountain.
Absolutely.
It's a funny world, you know. This time in my career, I pictured myself being married to an heiress.
Gentlemen, I think I got something good.
What? What?
I snuck into this fancy house. Acted like a servant girl. Usually works. Someone was saying her sister was taking a trip from New York or someplace. Train full of rich tourists heading to Saint Denis and then cruising off to Brazil.
Okay.
A train laden with baggage and passing through a bit of deserted country at night as to get to the docks in time for the tides in some place called Scarlet Meadows.
Yeah, I know it. Yeah, it's right out near New Hanover. Right, it's real quiet out there.
Sounds good. Where's Tilly and Karen?
I think at the hotel. They were picking up some drunken fellas that they was gonna rob.
Why?
It seemed easy. They have been gone for quite a while.
I guess I'll go see if there's any trouble.
Oh, there's Tilly over there. That does not look ideal.
Excuse me.
Me.
You thought I wouldn't find you, Tilly?
You can go kiss a damn snake for all I care. Get off me! Get off of me!
I've been looking too long.
Get your hands off her, friend.
Who are you?
A friend of mine.
Get off her.
Or what exactly?
You want to find out?
You're making a big mistake, Tilly Jackson.
Just get lost.
I ain't doing this with you.
Go wait with Uncle and Mary Beth. They're across the street.
Okay. Thanks, Arthur.
Uncle! Look after her. I'm gonna go see about Karen in the hotel.
I damn near broke my finger putting a feller in line last night. Some jaws.
Can I help you, sir?
Help people.
What can you do?
I do all I can manage. Are you doing all you can?
You looking for a room? No trouble now, please.
Oh, get the hell out of here, will you?
Sorry. Wrong room. Friend of hers.
Get out of here, buddy. I paid.
Ain't paid a hitter, you goddamn animal. Come here.
I paid for nothing. Think you two could spam me?
That's what happens. What the hell are you doing here?
Trying to play him. Not very well.
You okay?
Fine.
You sure?
Yeah. Nothing to worry about. Just men, but stupid bastard was boasting about the bank.
The bank?
Sure, I know small town banks are usually a waste of time, but this is a livestock town. There's lots of cash sometimes.
Everything's okay up there? Okay. Keep investigating.
I will.
After you.
Thank you, Arthur. I don't much like being saved, but when I have to be.
I understand.
You okay?
Sure. He only punched me. Arthur punched him a lot harder.
All right, then.
Hey, who's that guy over there looking at us?
Weren't you in Blackwater a few weeks back?
Me? No, sir. Ain't from there.
Oh, you were. Well, I definitely saw you with a bunch of fellas.
Me? No. Impossible. Listen, buddy. Come here for a minute.
I saw you.
Come here.
Come on, get...
I don't like this. Me neither. Go get the girls home. I'm gonna go have a word with our friend.
Be careful, Arthur.
Just a word. Yeah.
Hey, that's my horse.
Just borrowing it.
You stay away from me.
Get back here right now.
Don't go.
Help me! Help someone!
Why are you telling lies about me?
No. I got it wrong, partner. I got it very wrong. Now please help me up.
I ain't never been in Blackwater.
Then why are you chasing me?
I've got an unfortunate face.
Yes, me too. Now please pull me up, please. Just pull me up, come on!
All right, come on. You okay, partner?
No, I am not. I'm a mess.
Well, you ain't dead.
There is that. Jimmy Brooks.
I think it's best for both of us if we pretend this never happened.
Well, I agree. You saved my life. You're a good man, and Here, you want a pen? It's one of them steel ones.
Oh, that's very kind of you. But I'm not a good man, Jimmy Brooks. Not usually. You see, I was in Blackwater. I kill people. And maybe I should have killed you.
Should I have killed you, Jimmy Brooks?
Me? I never saw you. Not now, not never. I think we have an understanding.
Of course we do. Jimmy Brooks. I will remember that. I've got a good memory.
I haven't. Not one lick. Not one cent in this here old mind. Come on. Come on. You have a nice day now, sir. Yeah.
Yep.
Hey! My horse! Am I glad to see you?
Here's your horse back, friend.
Oh! You really were just borrowing it.
Appreciate it.
Evening, mister. Hey, don't mention the patrol. I don't think you should just be wandering around here, friend. Not a thing happens round here without an O'Driscoll saying so. Understand me?
Consider this a warning.
Go on! Get lost!
There's no more warnings coming. Got it?
Hey, Arthur.
To watch women in the outhouse and get caught. You also taught me not to worry about nothing other than that which is gonna happen.
Hey, Mrs. Arthur.
What